today I want to ask one more question. Are you ready to answer? Good. So what is truth? What is truth? You know, right? Truth and false. Right? So what is truth? Anybody knows? What is truth? This question was asked in the Bible also. Pilate, you know, Pilate? Yeah, who condemned Jesus, right? Pilate asked Jesus the same question. What is truth? And what is the answer Jesus gave? Anybody remembers? Anybody? Did Jesus answer for Pilate? No. When Pilate is asking what is truth, Jesus was silent. He didn't say anything. Because that question is not to know, to understand, to believe, but it is just negating. Pilate is not ready to understand, but he just want to question. But today in the prayer, chapter 17, we heard from Gospel of John, Jesus is praying for his disciples as he is leaving, because 18th chapter we have Passion and Jesus crucifixion, then resurrection. Now we are in the Easter days, ready to receive the Pentecost, but we are meditating on this Last Supper's prayer. It is called unity prayer. Jesus is praying for all the disciples, which means he is praying for everyone. Jesus is praying, Lord, keep my children from evil one. Protect them and consecrate them. With what? Consecrate them in truth. And what is truth? Jesus is telling, as sister already said. And we all proclaim that just before. Alleluia, alleluia. You said, your word, O Lord, is truth. Sanctify us in truth. Then again we sang, alleluia, alleluia. Jesus says, word is truth. And he also said in John 14, I am the way, truth and life. And Jesus is the truth. And word is Jesus himself. Word became flesh. People like Pilate, learned people, search for the wisdom, ask the question, what is truth? But they don't believe the truth personified in Christ, the word, the living word. One such person was Saint Justin, who lived in the first century, in the early second centuries. He was a philosopher and he was searching. He want to know the truth, true wisdom. Bible says wisdom is the fear of God. True wisdom comes when we fear God. But this Justin was going around and studying a lot of philosophies, Socrates, Plato, Stoic, Pythagoras, whatever available philosophies. You know what is philosophy means? Okay, philo means love. Sophia means wisdom. So love of wisdom means philosophy. So people who want to earn wisdom, they are philosophers. This Justin also was going around learning, but he was not satisfied because he is not getting the proper answers. And Saint Augustine also says, like, our heart is restless until we rest in God. So Justin was restless to find his answers, and finally he met a venerable Christian. We don't know his name. Then he started speaking with him, and finally this Christian elderly person introduced Christ to Justin, and he showed him the Old Testament prophets are more greater than the philosophers. So you just start reading them. Then Justin started reading the Bible. Then finally he encountered Jesus and he became a Christian. In the first reading, we heard Paul is saying, remember that after some time, people will come among you, not sparing the flock. They will arise men speaking twisted things to draw away the disciples after them. Therefore, be alert. In the early Christian church, first 3 centuries, people were confused when some faith-related questions were asked. Some people were not able to explain. So that's what Paul is speaking in the first reading. So some people were teaching very strangely. For example, one preacher was preaching, Old Testament is bad, New Testament is good. Justin corrects that. And New Testament is the fulfillment of the Old Testament. And after some time, there was another person, Marcius, who started preaching this heresy. And Justin exactly defended the faith. He's called one of the fathers of the church. Though he is not a priest, he remained as a philosopher in search of true wisdom. And once he found Christ, the truth and the wisdom, he started sharing that true wisdom to the people in his own way as a Christian philosopher. And he's the first apologist. Apologist means who answers the questions of the faith, who explains. So he's the first apologist. And officially, he wrote books explaining the Christian faith in the early centuries. Many, many books. First apology, second apology. Means like defending the faith directly to the emperor and to the entire empire. He started telling. Then finally, when his faith was questioned by the emperor, he stood strong. As St. Paul said in today's first reading, it is blessed to give than receive. Justin was ready to give even his life. And that's why today we remember him in this Holy Eucharist and we celebrate his feast day on June 1st. As we enter in this month of June, let us also pray along with our Pope Francis as he requests each one of us to pray for the families. June month, Pope's intentions. Pray for the family so that we might be strengthened to experience God's love and to witness God as Justin witnessed the world, the truth and the wisdom